Good evening. You're watching the evening news. It's our top story is another shocker from the UP police. After showering rose petals on Kanwariyas from a chopper, an SP of Shamli has been captured on camera giving a foot massage to a Kanwariya. This video of the officer was shared via the official Twitter account of the Shamli police. The tweet said, Shri Ajay Kumar inaugurated a newly set up medical camp in the district, especially for Kanwariyas. The Kanwar Yatra is the annual pilgrimage for the devotees of Shiva known as Kanwariyas, and it hits its peak celebrations in UP and Uttarakhand. So it is the Kanwariyas season in UP, like I said, and like last year, the top police and government officials have taken to the skies to shower flower petals on pilgrims as they make their way across UP on major pilgrimage routes. And the move to shower petals on them comes on the orders from the very top, from the Chief Minister Adityanath, who has ordered that all possible arrangements be made for the Kanwariyas. And the similar exercise took place last year, and there was much criticism then over choppers being used by top cops for these showering of petals. The government then said that that the officers were engaged in surveillance, the petals were just an added on, and the UP government had spent lakhs of rupees in hiring choppers for the exercise, and questions were raised. But it seems like this year too, practice is going to continue.
The annual Kanwar pilgrim season is at its peak. Uttar Pradesh is a hub for these Kanwariyas, and the UP government led by Yogi Adityanath has once again started what some would perhaps interpret as a rather peculiar practice of showering petals on these pilgrims and using top police officers and government officers for it. Footage from Western UP shows top police officers, including the additional director general of a zone there, including district magistrates, some using helicopters, some standing on the road and showering petals on these Kanwariya pilgrims. The practice of using these helicopters for showering petals is rather intriguing. Now, there are those who have criticized this, saying that it serves no purpose and is wasteful expenditure. The government says that is not the case. They say that they have hired these choppers for surveillance, and they say that showering petals on these Kanwariyas is an add-on and that they are well within their right to do something like this. Now, like I said, the footage available in the last 24 hours or so shows a host of top police officers actually getting onto helicopters and showering petals, throwing these petals on the pilgrims from above. What purpose that serves, we're not very sure, but like I said, the government has been defending it. In 2018, a similar practice was done at least for 2 or 3 days during the peak Kanwariya time. And at that point of time, reports have suggested that the government had hired choppers for 2 major Kanwariya routes in UP for at least 14 lakh rupees. Now, there were many who said, who criticized the government at that point of time, saying that you are only using these choppers to shower petals. The government, like I have said earlier, said that no, that's not the case. This is going on nevertheless, despite the criticism. The government says they will continue to do it. I did read somewhere that even the Chief Minister, Mr. Yogi Adityanath, could get onto a chopper and do something like this, but that is not confirmed. What is very visible is the UP police and the administration attempts to shower petals on these pilgrims. They say it is not appeasement. They say this is just normal thing. There are those who say that's not the case, but at the moment, it's certainly happening.
All right, we have now in a studio, in our studios here, we have Mr. Vikram Singh, former DGP of the UP Police. We also have Sharad Pradhan, senior journalist, joining us from Lucknow, and Mr. Deshratan Nigam, political analyst. So, first to you. Clearly, the Kanwariyas, they enjoy official sanction, they have patronage from the government, but this is an embarrassment to the UP police where you've served.
Let them do whatever they want to do as far as patronage is concerned. The police have a soldier-like conduct to perform. They're supposed to ensure traffic management, law and order, and as far as throwing and showering petals, this is not a police function. Similarly, massaging the foot is certainly not a police. I'm appalled to see a person in the entire with headgear and an entire uniform massaging the feet. I ask you 2 questions, and I'm a little agitated by the conduct of this uniformed officer. He seems to be a direct IPS officer. I had expected better. Very disappointing.
But what? But
I would say.
Is he in a hard place?
He's in a very hard place. Shamli
because the orders, as we're reporting, and as Aluk Pandey is saying, have come right from the top, from the Chief Minister.
I don't think they will be ordered because these are, if there are orders, these are illegal orders. You're supposed to do police functions. And this is not a police function. The police function is to ensure proper conduct. I have been in the police for 36 years. I have never even offered a bouquet to any political person. My salute is equal to 1,000 bouquets. And to massage the foot, I would ask two questions. Have you massaged the feet of your parents and of the sick and the destitute of your force who are in the police hospital? I don't think he would even have visited the police hospital once.
All right. Mr. Nigam, these are illegal orders from the top. They're coming from the top. So the government here, yes, they may want to patronize this because this is a vote bank, but they are doing something illegal and putting police officers in a very unfortunate position.
No, throwing petals is something, I don't think there's anything wrong in it. And then the state doing it, the state does lot of, you know, makes lot of arrangements for, you know, the namazes, the huge namazes that takes place, and they offer water also and things like that. So I don't read much into it. Now, second portion of the person, I don't have the complete facts of the person. That person is lying in a hospital. Was his condition bad that, or the doctor suggested somebody should massage his foot or something?
So the we, SP I should don't,
no,
be,
he should not
should be on, massaging on, no, someone's
no,
feet.
No, no,
is that where it starts?
No, no.
It starts with rose petals not, now, and SP is massaging
not,
their
not a part of his official duty, certainly not, and certainly not during his official hours, and certainly not in his uniform. He could have done so in a private, but it appears that person is in a hospital, is not in a good condition, and it also appears that there could be a possibility, maybe doctor suggested, because the entire story is not out, we are only showing one aspect of the visual. I do not have the complete facts, but on the face of it,
and the
it
aspects of the visual are like you're saying, there's a police officer, he is the SP, he is in
so
uniform.
That sends a wrong message.
And he is massaging the feet
See,
of
that
Kanwariyas.
Aspect, that limited aspect sends a wrong message unless until you know the complete context in what has happened.
So you believe there could be a context where it's okay for a police officer to be massaging the foot of
not
somebody
in the uniform,
who is critical
I said,
while,
not,
the, while the
not
doctor
in
just
the uniform,
stands there.
Maybe the doctor suggested because we don't have the complete context to this.
So the doctor stands there and suggests that a police officer massage someone's feet.
I would say it's a worst case scenario that the Kanwariya is on his deathbed and does not have very long. It is not for the district SP to massage the feet. There are paramedics, there are doctors,
correct,
and there are better people to administer that treatment to him, and certainly not the SP in charge of a district in full uniform.
Mr. Nigam, you know, I really want to ask, this is the same state where the Chief Minister, where in 2017 we saw 70 children almost die in the Gorakhpur hospital because of lack of oxygen tanks. This year we've seen about 60 children die in because of encephalitis. You have lakhs that the government can spend on helicopters, like you're saying, to shower rose petals. Maybe there's nothing wrong with that. Like you say, namaz, some arrangements are put in place for people to do namaz. But what are the priorities of this government then?
The priorities of the government are very, very clear out there. The law and order, they are doing it very fine. They have taken in the right spirit. 60 people that you're talking about is not in UP this year, but in Bihar you are talking about
encephalitis deaths, even in UP.
Every
year in UP.
No, in Gorakhpur, which was the center, it has been controlled. Which is one of the landmark efforts of the UP government. And certainly in Bihar we had a problem, and everybody criticized, and we all were on the same page. And the priorities are very clear. Today also, 65,000 crore investments are being inaugurated today. The entire investments of just for one day. So the things are going on. So we have to see it in the right perspective. Yes, on the face of it, this visual of SP, certainly in uniform, is not going down my throat.
But as we're reporting here, this is a medical facility that has been set up to provide amenities to Kanwariyas on the route while they're doing their pilgrimage. At the same time, I think there's some app that I was reading somewhere that they can go onto this app and find out where you can find the closest facilities, etc. If this kind of preparation have been put into place even to deal with the medical issues, again, like I'm saying, every year we hear of encephalitis. Gorakhpur Hospital happened 2017. You don't see that kind of preparation that the government puts or involvement that the government puts into those issues.
That also, they are doing it. The way they controlled the Gorakhpur issues in 2017, it has not recurred. So they have taken, it was going on prior to that. So it had a long history, but now it has been controlled. Bihar has issues. I am sure Bihar government must look into it and they must do it. But in UP, I think things are on the right track. The development is going on a very fast track. Foreign investment is being attracted. The roads are very good if you compare it to many, many other states. And I stay in Ghaziabad, which is in UP. Certainly, law and order has improved since last 2-3 years.
Law and order this season, when you have the Kanwariyas all on the roads taking over and the cops are unable to stop them almost. Let's go across to Mr. Sharad Pradhan. We're talking about law and order now specifically, and there are scores of videos that you can see on social media, photographs. You have Kanwariyas. Last year there was an episode where they were smashing cars. There was a woman driver. There are episodes of them misbehaving with commuters. And then you have official gestures like this of this police officer in uniform massaging the feet of a Kanwariya. Does that not embolden the lumpen elements of these pilgrims?
Yeah, I wish, I would have agreed with Mr. Nigam if they all Kanwariyas were real holy people. We all know, everybody knows, and whoever now doesn't know is highly ignorant. In fact, most of the Kanwariyas are not genuinely high-class devotees. I mean, by high-class, I mean sincere devotees. There, many of them are could be rogues wearing that. Anybody, I could become a Kanwariya. So there is no such to believe that anybody who calls himself a Kanwariya is a sincere devotee is highly a reflection of somebody's ignorance. Secondly, when he says that this police officer is doing it in a hospital, I don't see any semblance of the hospital. That table is not a hospital table at all. It is. But whatever.
No, it is a center that has been set up to provide medical facilities to Kanwariyas. The question is, should the police officer be providing these so-called facilities, which may include a foot massage?
That is, giving a foot massage is not the job of a police officer. Why should he be doing it? None of them are paramedics. Whoever is standing there except that fellow in white, he should be a paramedic. He's just smiling away. Obviously, the man on the table is not in distress or pain. Because none of them look concerned when he's a serious patient. This is not the kind of which Mr. Nigam needs to look at once again. And Mr. Nigam needs the defend the indefensible. And I against that, to it being a partner.
All right. So, Mr. Nigam, please respond to that. That we move very far from the original concept of, the pilgrimage. The original idea of being a Kanwariya has changed completely. It's become hugely commercialized. I don't think anybody will argue about that. And also hugely politicized. This is clearly now a vote bank for the UP government. You also see Kanwariyas, before they used to wear saffron, plain cotton shirts. Now they're all wearing these t-shirts. Many of them are wearing t-shirts provided, I'm not sure by who, but that have the image of both the Chief Minister and the Prime Minister Modi.
See, first let me respond to Mr. Pradhan that to comment on the devotion of Kanwariyas and, making them all or not, that is neither my cup of tea nor his cup of tea. You cannot question somebody else's devotion and the way they are doing it. Now, so far as
why not? If it's changed from the original concept.
No, there is no nothing called. See, let me tell you. That is why Hinduism. There is no set rules. Please understand.
So you can play Bollywood music while
yes,
you're on a pilgrimage.
Yes.
Okay.
Bollywood music, the kind of which has been converted
but
into
right
bhajans.
Now,
see, let me tell you. Lot of bhajans today are on the tunes of Bollywood music. We don't have any set of rules that it has to be like this. But however, if you're going by scriptures and doing shloks, that have to be done in a particular manner.
Yet
while
the
Chief
Minister has said that you can't, DJs can't play music that aren't
bhajans. That comes under the law of pollution, noise pollution, that you cannot play.
He's not saying don't play loud music. He's saying play bhajans. You should only play bhajans, Bollywood and all
see,
that.
That's his personal opinion, let me tell you. But there is no rule that prevents you. Hinduism is not like a religion based on books where things are codified like Christianity and Islam. We have a complete range from A to B spectrum where you move from multiplicity to monotheism, a single God. And there are various shades in between. Yes, it has to be within the parameters of law and order. No hooliganism, nothing. And then the rest is up to you.
So is anyone cracking down on the hooliganism? That seems to have taken over a large part of...
No, we don't have many serious issues this time. Last time there was one incident which happened in Delhi where they had upturned a car or something. But
yes.
Today, Today, the last time, there may be minor issues.
And after that upturning of the car in Bulandshahr, a police vehicle was smashed. There were some 60 Kanwariyas and a police vehicle was smashed. So if you can take on the police, you know that there's nobody there who can hold you back. Even when this woman's car was attacked, the police stood by.
That was last time.
Are the police empowered to take on a Kanwariya?
Yes, obviously they are.
Absolutely. The police are empowered to take on the Kanwariyas, and if there are no exceptions, and there shouldn't be any. The problem, the logistic problem arises only because of the huge crowd, the reinforcements do not manage to reach the scene of crime early. They have to walk it or they have to clear the roads, and that is an issue, and that needs to be reinforced through aerial assault units or aerial reconnaissance. That is
but
why the chopper was there. Not to shower
more loyal
petals.
Than the king. The problem is that more often than not, they turn more loyal, the cops, in order to please get some brownie points from the top political level. They become more loyal than the king, and they ensure that Kanwariyas have a free time, a free day. Whoever they might be, just because they call themselves Kanwariyas, they believe. And who doesn't know?
But to the credit of the police.
An ignorant man will believe that every Kanwariya claiming himself to be a Kanwariya is a sincere Kanwariya. Hinduism also says that you have honest and truthful and truly committed. Not about, then the word called imposter. And there are no dearth of imposters. Especially in the religion is concerned, irrespective of religion. There are a lot of imposters who claim but don't mean it.
So, Mr. Pradhan, the government here seems to be standing by. In many cases, you see the police standing by when there's hooliganism. And then that hooliganism tramples on the basic rights of an average citizen, you know, to get to work on time, simple things like that. All of that gets affected. Is this a vote bank, and the government is playing to this vote bank now?
Absolutely. What could be more? You have hit the nail on the head. That is precisely what is being done. This is a clear-cut example of vote bank politics. The idea is to show that this, you know, the chief minister believes in a lot of display, and this is one occasion when he gets a chance to display that he is all for the for Hinduism. If this is what and because, you know, having been the head of a monastery, what you call a matadish, whatever he starts believing, he wants everybody else to believe that. And the reality, far from what you see, is far from reality.
Okay, but I want to play devil's advocate. You know, urban middle class often has a contempt for these Kanwariyas. But in reality, maybe it is just a few. There's such large numbers. There are few of these hooligans who get away. Few of these men who you're saying are hooligans, not really there with the real concept of penance. And they are giving a bad name to the entire process. Is that not also possible?
That is certainly possible. That is what happens. We have seen how the Sadhu Babas, how they are giving a bad name. I mean, there's nothing wrong in being in priesthood. But the kind of Babas we have, like the likes of Asaram and Ram Rahim and many others. So what do you do? And they are not limited to just Hindus. They are in all religions. Fake Babas. So are we expected, just because somebody is a Baba, to just keep pay obeisance to him? Right or wrong, he may kick you in the face till you pay. He may rape girls. You keep on because he's a Baba.
Well, in the end, the onus lies on the government, and the government needs to crack down. The government involved. I'm going to give the last word to you, Mr. Singh, because you are a former DGP and you've served in UP. The last word to you. What would you say to officers who are watching this video? What message are they supposed to imbibe from it? Where are they supposed to get the strength to even stand up to orders coming from the top?
I have served in this area for many years in most of the important capacities, and I know it's a difficult job. Last year, they had more than 2 crores people. Today, they can expect more. Yesterday, they gave an excellent account. But I would expect a police officer to be a police officer in a no-nonsense manner, to be 200 police officers. Massaging the feet of Kanwariya is not your job. Showering petals is not your job. Your job is to be a surgical police officer, maintain respectable distance, lest you be branded that you are partisan. Therefore, be a professional police officer and do not shy away from doing your duty. And if there are illegal orders, you are under no obligation to carry out illegal orders.
Under no obligation to carry out illegal orders, but easier said than done. But thank you so much for all of you coming in to discuss this topic today. Thank you.